Ahoj, já jsem Štěpán Dokoupil.
Hello, my name is Štěpán Dokoupil and I am the founder of 3DLabPrint, where we develop various types of RC aircraft models designed for 3D printing. This idea was born around 2014 and in 2015 we launched our first ready-to-print aircraft. Over the following years, we have created around 50 different models for you to download and print. Our main focus is on World War II planes. I think they are the most beautiful propeller planes around. But we also have some jet aircraft, like the MiG-15 and the American Sabre 86. These two are wonderful opponents that fought during the Korean War. And now you have the chance to print them and even reenact dogfights with them, if you like. And here is the Waco. It's an American sport biplane, very popular and it's really easy to fly. It's a bit more demanding to create, meaning it takes a longer time to print it, but the results are totally worth it, and flying the Waco is amazing. And this is one of our latest warplanes, the World War II Messerschmitt Bf 109 V3. We had to tweak a few things to make it fly better, because the original could be a bit difficult to control. To give you an example, we adjusted the wing angles in a few places so that the wing is slightly twisted along its length, which increases the dynamics of the aircraft. With these changes, the plane doesn't stall as easily and is more stable at low speeds. That's very important for smooth and easy landings. We have also slightly increased the size of the horizontal stabilizers to further improve stability. And we have improved the center of gravity by lengthening the nose. We provide easy to understand assembly instructions with each of our models, in both PDF and video format. The instructions are divided into chapters according to the parts they cover, like the fuselage, wings, electronics, engine, servos, and each chapter is accompanied by video and links to websites where you can buy the recommended equipment. So let me show you the electronics. Everything is under this cover. To make an RC model fly, we need an electronic speed controller, or ESC for short, which controls the speed of the motor. Then there is the receiver, and here's the space for the battery, which is usually held in place by a Velcro strip. As for the total cost of the extra equipment you'll need to buy, it's about $150. It's not a small amount of money, but our planes are quite large, so you need to select the parts accordingly. Still, you can save maybe half the money compared to the pre-built sets available in the shops. When it comes to realism and accuracy, it needs to be said that there is a certain compromise that has to be made to make the smaller scale aircraft fly well. We can't just blindly copy the real plane and adjust the scale. There are a number of things that have to be different. The profiles on the wings, the size of the wing surfaces to increase the stability of the plane, and so on. That's because the physical forces act differently on larger wings, so they don't translate well to scale replicas. The internal weight distribution is also completely different. It's very easy to make a model with the center of gravity too far back near the tail, which makes the plane extremely difficult to control. It becomes unstable and it can, for example, overreact to the slightest input from the user. That's why we need to move the center of gravity closer to the leading edge of the wing. This makes the plane more stable, with a smoother response to the controls, making it more forgiving of the mistakes you might make as a beginner. PLA is an excellent material for printing aircraft. It's less prone to shrinkage when it cools, so you can print large parts with just a single perimeter, and it holds its shape and doesn't warp. On the other hand, PLA is quite heavy and brittle. Its density is 1200 kilograms per cubic meter, or 75 pounds per cubic foot. That's why we also make the other type of filament, lightweight active foam PLA. When you print this filament, the foaming effect is activated as it passes through the nozzle of the 3D printer, and the material can expand up to 2.5 times, depending on temperature settings and other factors. This means we can reduce the flow of the filament in the nozzle to around 50 or maybe even 40%, reducing the overall weight of the printed object by half. It has a very nice surface finish, a soft matte surface that is easy to color. The downside is that the printed object is slightly weaker, but the reduced weight is well worth it. In this way, we can achieve the same or very similar weight to other popular technologies such as balsa wood, EPP foam or laminate. I'm very happy that we have been able to achieve this with our filaments. Weight and wing surface loading, which are related to the weight and size of the wings, are the key aspects of all models. With a lighter plane, you can fly slower and have better control. This in turn makes landing easier, which is extremely important for beginners. If you build your first 3D printed airplane from our lightweight PLA with active foam effect, it will be much easier to land, minimizing the possibility of unwanted damage. The kinetic energy on landing is a quarter of that of a heavier plane, so there's much less risk. Our latest model is the Piper J3 Cub, an American high wing plane. It is super easy to fly, so if you're looking for your first model, this is a perfect choice. It can be printed using just 200 grams of polylite filament, so it's very light. You can easily print 4 planes from a single spool of filament, so you don't have to worry about crashing your plane. You can easily make plenty of spare parts. So if you don't make the landing, you can just print another plane and swap out the electronic parts so you can start flying again in no time. That's the great thing about 3D printing. You don't have to wait for the parts to arrive in a couple of days. You can simply print spare parts at home and use them when you need them. In this case, for as little as $50, you can build this simple, lightweight airplane with the proper landing gear. We will also add a hydroplane variant, so you'll be able to take off and land on water. And we are also planning other updates for our existing models. We need to redesign some of the older models so they are fully compatible with our lightweight active foam PLA. I started modeling in 3D Studio Max, which is a very well-known software, often used in architecture for visualization, which is something I used to do. So I knew very well how to use it. I'm not saying it's the single best tool for modeling, because nowadays you can choose from plenty of capable applications. It depends on whether you prefer polygonal or parametric modeling. 3ds Max is the former. Basically, you drag points around the 3D space. It's based on the principle that each plane, each polygon, is defined by at least 3 points. That's how it works. I've recently switched to Blender, which is free, and I see a future in that. I think Blender is a very cool piece of software. It basically uses the same modeling principles as 3D Studio Max, but it also has a lot of options. For example, in terms of 3D scanning and editing 3D scans and so on. Plus, of course, there's the fact that Blender is free. 3D Studio Max costs over $200 a month, and there is only the subscription. You can't even buy it and own it. Blender is free and you can do pretty much the same things with it. But I don't think the software itself is too important. There will always be those never-ending internet discussions where everyone praises the software they know the best. When you design the aircraft, you're really tailoring it to a specific slicer profile. The slicer has to understand your 3D model, and you have to get the slicer to actually slice it exactly the way you want it. There's a big difference between, for example, modeling the aircraft for Cura and Simplify. We recently switched to Prusa slicer, which is perfectly compatible with our planes since version 2.4. So thank you for that, guys. So we are now in the process of adapting our previous models for Prusa slicer. Designing the large models from scratch takes about 3 months. That means 1 to 2 months of painstaking modeling. It's a really tedious process. You simply have to spend that time on it. Most of the time we can work with blueprints. We'll find the right resources, whether it's historical blueprints, fuselage sections, wing sections, photo documentation, and then we just start designing it. Then we 3D print the first prototype, add all the necessary equipment, and we fly it. Usually, it turns out that it still needs a bit of tweaking. For example, it's not stable, or it's not easy to land, or perhaps it has a tendency to stall even at higher speeds, or maybe it turns out that the strength of the frame is not enough. So even though we have more than 5 years of experience, it may still happen that we have to reinforce some parts, increase certain areas, or change the curvature of the wing, or perhaps the tension of the wing. So there are still various challenges, like when it turns out that certain mounts on either the landing gear or the wing are not strong enough and we need to adjust that. All in all, these little fixes can take another month of work. Then we test it again, and at this point everything goes well usually. So we can split everything into easily printable parts, we make videos, write instructions and tutorials, and record videos, which also takes a lot of time, but the assembly instructions are vital. If you are building your first airplane, you will really appreciate them. Then, of course, we upload the data to our website, we also include various bonuses like liveries, for example. So after 3 months of work, everything's online and you can download it and print it. We have customers from all over the world. Australia, Japan, France, Germany, the US, Canada. It's a global phenomenon. I am actually an architect originally and have been interested in aviation all my life. I enjoy technology, and the moment I heard about 3D printers, I thought that I would get one for architectonic models and so on, but when I brought home the 3D printer, I started wondering if I could print an airplane on it. That was around 2014. So for 6 months, I kept working day and night to create the first prototype of a Spitfire with a span of about a meter, and I got it airborne. So that was on Christmas Day in 2014, December 24th, and at that time the plane had some specific design choices, like batteries in the wings. That was an inspiration from the real aircraft that had fuel in the wings, but the further development showed that this wasn't entirely necessary and I could use a different approach. 3D printing has the beautiful and huge advantage that you can construct pretty much anything. You can make very specific shapes. You can make support structures inside the wings that would be impossible with other technologies. So even if the PLA filament is not ideal compared, for example, to carbon fiber, metal or wood, you are able to make up for these disadvantages of the material by using smart designs and 3D support structures. And the printer doesn't care if the wing is simple or complex, it just prints it. So that's the biggest advantage of 3D printing. I think that this kind of advantage is going to become even more important over time, and it will change the way we design things. Look at how airplanes are made today. Companies have been making large airplanes for about 100 years, and 100 years the same way. There is a workshop and the engineers who just put those planes together in a very similar way, although the tools have developed and RC models used to be made the same way. We are taking it a little bit further. The model is completely designed in 3D software on the computer, and you don't have to be an engineer or a craftsman to actually make the plane. You just let the 3D printer do all the work for you. I think we are experiencing very exciting times, which will have a huge impact on the future. So maybe in 50 years, we'll manufacture everything this way.